Hi guys, my name is Ashley and I'm a mom of two little girls. I have a 3.5-year-old named Kylie and I also have a 17-month-old named Mia. Real quick before we start the video, I just wanted to apologize up front if the sound quality is at all echoey or off sounding to you. I am not able to film in my normal filming location today. Please bear with me for this week and hopefully by next week we will be back to normal video quality. And I also wanted to briefly share with you, just in case you don't follow along with our weekly family vlogs, that in the last vlog, my husband and I announced that he has just launched a brand new business that is focused on Montessori materials. It's called Montessori and Me. I will leave a link in the description box down below if you're interested in checking it out. And without further ado, I would like to jump right into today's video. So from one busy parent to another, today I'd like to share with you activity ideas that are geared specifically for your preschooler in your Montessori home. So one thing that I'd like to point out is that all of the activities that you're about to see are completely appropriate to use in your Montessori home, whether or not you are homeschooling. So if you're just looking for some extra fun activities to try out, you're not doing any sort of formal homeschooling at home, that is totally fine. These activities would still be fun and engaging for your preschool age child, and that would be roughly 2.5 to 3 years old, all the way up to about 6, and would be developmentally appropriate to introduce. However, I have organized the activity ideas that I'm about to present in this video by the different learning areas that you would see in a traditional Montessori preschool classroom. So if you do happen to be homeschooling, then hopefully that will help you to organize your thoughts a little bit more so that you can really kind of see exactly where these different activities would fit into your Montessori preschool homeschool curriculum. And this is by no means an exhaustive list. There are literally hundreds of different preschool activities that fall into the Montessori 3 to 6 years old curriculum. So consider this just a little sampling. It's some of the things that I'm currently doing with my preschooler at home that I thought would be fun to share with you guys. So let's jump into it. So the first category of activities is gross motor, which I feel is often overlooked, but your preschool-aged child still has a lot of energy to expel every single day. So as much as you can get your child outside riding a pedal tricycle or even a balance bike, that is an excellent way to help them burn off all that extra energy and also work on those all-important gross motor skills. In addition, spending time outdoors and just being in nature provides your child with a lot of really wonderful sensorial opportunities that you don't have to recreate inside on a shelf. They just naturally exist. Allowing your child to just explore and figure out how to maneuver their own bodies over different uneven surfaces is wonderful for their gross motor development, but it really just allows them to also get in touch with nature, to dig for worms and feel soil between their fingers and their toes, or just sit outside in the sunshine, drawing with a bucket of chalk, feeling the wind in their hair. These are opportunities that cannot be created inside of the home. They can only be found outside. And honestly, nature is one of the best boredom busters. So next time you're feeling like you need a little bit of a reset button for you or your child, head outside. It will be well worth it. However, there are a whole series of sensorial activities and materials in a Montessori environment, and one that you can easily DIY at home for your child, which they find very engaging, is silhouette matching. For this activity, your child is presented with two sets of cards, one that includes a set of objects and then another with their matching silhouettes. And your child's task is to match the correct object with the corresponding silhouette. And if you're finding that your child enjoys this activity, but they need a little bit more of a challenge, you can also use the cards for a game of memory where the matching pairs are the object and its silhouette. Another sensorial activity to try is sorting by size, which helps to hone your child's visual discrimination skills and is an important prerequisite for later, more abstract math concepts. So in this activity, you're presenting your child with a series of cards that have different pictures on them, and for each picture, you have one that is big, one that is medium, and one that is small. And your child's challenge is to compare them against one another so that they can sort them correctly into big, medium, and small. And this activity is really easy to tailor to whatever your child might be studying if you're homeschooling or just something that they're interested in. So you can change up the pictures that you're using to just animals or just vehicles or just a certain category of something, objects around the house, whatever you can think of, it can be adapted for it. For the area of science, your preschooler can try classification. So for this activity, you're presenting your child with either a group of objects or a group of pictures, and you're asking them to sort the objects into two or more different categories, to whatever they belong, however they would naturally be broken up. So this is easy to apply to a lot of different scientific areas. For example, you can see in this one, my daughter is sorting a group of animal pictures into either mammals or not mammals. But this can also be done with geography, if you're sorting different locations, famous landmarks, things like that. But this activity can also be adapted for use with normal everyday objects that you find around your house as well. So for example, you could have your child sort various different types of silverware. Preschoolers tend to be very curious about the life cycles of different plants and animals that they encounter in their normal everyday environment or something that they're interested in learning about. And so something that might be fun to try is a multi-layer puzzle. Now these are just like normal jigsaw puzzles, except that they have literally different layers, and each layer corresponds to a different stage in the life cycle of that plant or animal. Now, language learning activities for a preschooler in a Montessori environment will always center on the child learning letter sounds as opposed to the names of the letters, at least in the beginning. And there are a whole series of very specific, beautiful Montessori materials that are designed to help the child master these letter sounds. But there are also several activities that you can do with your child at home with or without these materials. The first activity is something called the I Spy game, or sometimes it's called the sound game. And this activity is very exciting and fun for a child who is really interested in learning those letter sounds, because it's a hands-on way to do that. So all you need for this activity is a series of objects. You can use pictures, but objects are preferable because a young child prefers to have something to manipulate, to hold on to and look at. It really helps to cement their understanding a lot better. You can use toys, you can use clothing items, you can use food, you can use kitchen objects. It really doesn't matter as long as it's something that the child can handle. When first introducing the I Spy game, you really want to limit the child's choices to about three, because more than that can be a little bit overwhelming. But as your child gets better and they do start mastering more and more of the letter sounds, you can slowly introduce a greater number of objects at one time. So once you've picked out your three objects, here's how the game is played.
This is a Brussels sprout. This is
yummy Brussels sprout.
An orange.
After we're done.
Orange.
After that, I'm going to eat the orange.
Okay. This is a kiwi. Kiwi. Can you say kiwi?
Kiwi.
This is an apple. I spy with my little eye something that begins with the sound k.
Oh, I know, kiwi.
Kiwi, all right.
I know.
I spy with my little eye.
You know what? That kiwi is really ripe.
It is really ripe. We should eat it.
Yep, a wonderful orange.
Okay. I spy with my little eye something that begins with the sound b.
Brussels sprout.
Brussels sprout starts with the sound b.
Now the I Spy game is perfect to play with a child who is just starting out and really trying to learn to listen for those letter sounds that they're hearing at the beginning of different words. For a child who is actually learning what the different alphabet letters look like and associating the actual letter with the sound visually, you can then move on to another really fun game called object to letter matching. So for this game, your child is presented with a set of letters, and these can be sandpaper letters as you see here, but they don't have to be. They can also be a couple of index cards that have one letter drawn on each one in big chunky black marker that's very clear to see. But you'll give your child a set of letters along with a small set of objects where the beginning sounds of those objects matches with one of the letters. So your child's challenge is to lay out each of the letters and then match the correct objects to its beginning letter sound. So for example, here you see my daughter is matching the elephant to the letter E on the card, and she's just laying it on top. And as we said before, these objects can be anything. It does not have to be a small little miniature version of something. They can be anything that you find laying around your house. As long as your child can identify what it is, it can work for this activity. A variation on object to letter matching are these alphabet letter puzzles, and the idea here is the same. The child is matching the letter of the alphabet with the picture that has the corresponding beginning sound. And what's great about this puzzle set in particular is that it is self-correcting. So if the child makes a mistake and they match the wrong letter to the wrong picture, then the two puzzle pieces will not fit together and the child will know. For math activities, you might have your preschooler try out a set of number pegboards. In this activity, your child is learning how to place pegs into each of the pre-drilled holes on each number pegboard. And over time, after having done this enough, the child eventually learns to associate the quantity of pegs, exactly how many they've placed, with the abstract concept of the number symbol that is also printed on that board. So they can really begin to get a sense of what one looks like versus what seven of something looks like. A classic math activity that's introduced at the preschool level is the colored bead stare. In this activity, the child is presented with bead bars ranging in size from just one bead all the way up to 9 beads, or some sets have 10 beads. And the child's task is to first learn how to arrange the beads so that they are in sequential order from 1 all the way through 9. Once the child is able to do that, they are then asked to move on to the second step of the activity, which is associating each of the bead bars with the correct number symbol. And again, this does require them being able to practice that one-to-one correspondence, counting each bead in turn on the bar, and then selecting the appropriate number to match it. Like the last two activities, this one is designed to help your child really begin to get a natural sense of quantity and being able to associate it with that abstract number symbol. There are also a number of ways to DIY the Montessori colored bead stare, so you don't necessarily have to purchase a set of them, although you can if you want to. So I will leave links in the description box down below to a set that you can purchase and also a couple of really great DIY options. And just as a quick side note, this is the one material in this video that I would not recommend having at home if your child is attending an actual Montessori preschool outside of your home. You want to preserve your child's excitement about and engagement with the things that they're finding in their classroom. But if you are Montessori homeschooling, or if your child attends a traditional preschool and you just want to introduce some of these amazing Montessori materials at home, then that would be okay. But otherwise, I would save it for the classroom if your child has this material in their classroom. Another really fun way to introduce math concepts to your preschooler is through the use of board games. These are really wonderful learning tools because not only will they help your child learn very basic foundation math skills like color and shape recognition, number recognition, and counting, but they also help to reinforce a set of social skills that a child would ordinarily learn in the grace and courtesy curriculum in a Montessori classroom. For example, turn taking. And in addition to all those things, board games are just a really fun way to laugh and have fun and bond with your child. Next up on the list are practical life activities, and preschoolers tend to find food preparation very engaging as it is a multi-sensory experience for them. So teaching them how to handle a knife and cut food properly without hurting themselves is a great skill for them to learn in the preschool years. Now, if your child has never handled a knife before, you probably want to start out with something a little bit smaller, like a child-sized butter knife with a blunt tip and much softer foods, like a banana or an avocado. But as your child's knife skills progress, you can introduce them to knives like you see here, which is actually a nylon chef's knife designed for children. Another wonderful practical life activity for preschoolers is flower arranging. Young children have an innate sense of order and an appreciation of beauty in their environment, the same as any adult. So if you give them the opportunity to add little touches of beauty to their own environment that they can contribute to and feel proud of, it's something that they find very interesting and engaging. And creating a simple flower arrangement is a really fun way to do that. To do this activity, you'll want to set up a little tray for your child that has all of the materials that they'll need to create the flower arrangement ahead of time. So think about including things like a small pitcher of water, maybe a small funnel for the neck of the vase, a small child-sized vase, a little bunch of fresh flowers if you have access to fresh flowers, or maybe just an artificial flower if they're learning and practicing, and then a small sponge or a washcloth to wipe up any accidental spills. And the first time that you present this, you'll want to show them how to do it so that they can see and understand the sequence of the steps and how to use each of the tools that you've given them on the tray. But after you've shown them the first time, then you can put the things back on the tray and allow them to use their own creativity in coming up with their own flower arrangement. You can then invite them to find a special little spot somewhere in your home to place it, either for themselves or for the whole family to enjoy. So if your child has their own small table where they perhaps have their snacks or maybe even eat their own meals, they might choose to place their flower arrangement on that table to enjoy while they're eating. But they might also choose to place it in a more communal space somewhere else in the home, perhaps on the family dining table for everyone else to enjoy as well. By the time your child is a preschooler, they are more than capable of assisting in all of the steps involved in doing a load of laundry. So having them actually gather the dirty clothes and putting them into the laundry basket if they're not already in there, and relocating that laundry basket from one room to wherever the clothes are being washed. And then if you have a washer and dryer, perhaps helping you load the clothes into the washing machine, adding the soap, adjusting the settings with your help, of course. And then after the clothes are washed, moving them to the dryer. And then once they're dry, taking them out of the dryer, putting them back into that laundry basket, and then helping you to fold them and put them away. If your child has never helped you with laundry before and this is new for them, then you want to start small. Don't ask them to do everything from beginning to end right away. But as they gain an understanding of how to complete each of the steps, then you can put more and more of the responsibility on them to help you out with each of the steps until they're capable of doing the entire process with you. A practical life activity that preschoolers find both challenging but also very intriguing is a set of locks and keys. So for this activity, you're presenting your child with a set of 3 to 5 different locks, and they're matching 3 to 5 different keys. And your child's challenge is to figure out which key goes with which lock, and then successfully actually open each of the locks and then close them again. If you happen to have pets in your home, then involving your preschooler in routine pet care is a great way to get them involved. Things like filling up your pet's water bowl and assisting with scooping and pouring out food for your pet each day. The same goes for any plants that you happen to have in your home. You can teach your preschooler not only how to water the plants with a child-sized watering can or just a garden hose if it's a much larger area, but you can also teach them how to tend to the plants, how to recognize when certain plants need trimming and how to actually do the trimming, as well as harvesting any fruits or vegetables. For a preschooler who is ready for a little bit more challenge in their wet pouring activities, you can ask them to fill a cup to the line. And for this activity, all you need to do is present your child with a pitcher of water that has more water than they need, and a cup that has a line drawn on it or a line marked off with tape, something very visible as a place for them to stop filling the water. Pouring to the line is actually a little bit of a challenge for children in the beginning because typically when they first learn how to pour, they're just kind of filling the cup up and sometimes it overflows completely. But as they learn how to pay attention, they can actually start to focus in on that line and make sure that they're only filling it up just to the line and that they're not overflowing it by accident, which is a really great prerequisite to not only pouring their own drinks at the table successfully without making a mess, but also for baking and measuring so that they know exactly where to fill up a measuring cup to. Learning how to use real tools is a very exciting activity for most preschoolers, and an easy, safe way to do this is to provide them with a screwdriver board. There are a few variations on this available for purchase in different locations online, and some of them have the same exact bolt but in different sizes. The particular one you're seeing in this video today, though, is a set that has a variety of different types of hardware and a couple of different tools that correspond to the different types of hardware. And the challenge here is for the child to not only learn how to get those different types of hardware in and out of the board, but also to be able to identify which tool is the proper tool to use for each of the different types. Not only is this activity wonderful for actually helping them learn how to use these different tools, but it's also a really wonderful work for strengthening those hand and finger muscles and that wrist movement that your child is going to need later on for learning how to write. Another great practical life activity for working on those fine motor skills is tweezer transfer. In this activity, you're providing your child with a small bowl of very small beads, and a normal size pair of tweezers that you yourself would use. And your child's challenge is to use the tweezers to pick up and transfer from one bowl to the other, one bead at a time. A preschool aged child is also capable of helping to unload a dishwasher or unload a dish rack, wherever you keep your clean dishes, and find their proper homes in your kitchen, wherever those things might be stored. Again, if this is something that is new to your child, then you're going to need to teach them from the very basics how to actually handle the things that are fragile so that they don't break. And you will have to model this yourself. You want to show them how to hold a plate or a bowl with two hands and to walk slowly. Even young toddlers can be taught how to do this. So by preschool age, they are more than ready for this challenge. And finally, there's pinpricking work. In this activity, your child is presented with a shape that has been drawn onto a small piece of paper and a corkboard or something to cushion it underneath and a large push pin. And the challenge for your child is to use the push pin to create many small holes along the outline of the shape. Enough holes that eventually they can just push the shape out of the piece of paper as if it had been cut out. This work does take a very long time and a lot of patience, so do not expect your child to do this all in one go unless it's a very small shape the first couple of times that they do it. But as your child's attention span and ability to focus and concentrate lengthens, for some preschoolers, this is an activity that will hold their attention for a very long time. And much like many of the other practical life activities, pinpricking work is wonderful for helping to develop your child's hand and finger strength, all of those really important fine motor skills that they need later on for writing. And one more category that I would be remiss not to mention, simply because it is so developmentally appropriate, even though it is not a Montessori activity, it is certainly Montessori friendly, and that is providing your child with open-ended building materials. So if you don't already have a small basket or a box with some of these open-ended materials in your child's play space available to them at all times, then I would highly recommend setting one up, because preschoolers are very engaged at this age in imaginative play and exploring their creativity. And it's just nice for them to have a place to go that they know is always there for these materials whenever they need them. So those are all of the ideas that I have to share with you today for Montessori preschool activities. I do have a lot more ideas forthcoming in future videos, so stay tuned. And if you are interested in learning more about how to implement Montessori practices at home with your children, I also offer a comprehensive e-course that you can check out that walks you through it step by step. So I'll be sure to leave a link in the description box down below, just in case you're interested in learning more about it. And just in case you are new to my channel, I also wanted to let you know that this video is part of a much larger series on this YouTube channel called Montessori at Home, which is aimed at providing practical tips and advice for busy parents like you and I for implementing Montessori at home with your children. So if that sounds like something that you're interested in watching more of, then you might consider subscribing to my channel. This way you don't miss a new video, because I do upload a new one just like this one every single week. Thank you so much for watching today, and I'll see you next time. Bye!